poem Brahma was written by Ralph Waldo Emerson in 1856. It is named after Brahma, the Hindu god of creation, and the speaker in the poem is also Brahma. Brahma is one of the gods in Trinity, Brahma, Vishnu, and Mahesh. It is a poem that presents an idea represented in Gita that soul is immortal. Ralph Waldo Emerson was an American essayist and poet who led the transcendentalist movement of the mid-19th century. He was seen as a champion of individualism, and he had deep knowledge of the Oriental philosophy, Bhagavad Gita and Vishnu Puran. He was born in 1803 and died in 1882. Emerson gradually moved away from the religious and social beliefs of his contemporaries, formulating and expressing his philosophy in his 1836 essay, Nature. In the first quatrain of the poem Brahma, we find that Brahma himself seems to be speaking to people. He says that if the red slayer means the person who kills, the person may be a Kshatriya, may be Goddess Durga, or anyone who sheds blood for a good cause. He thinks that the red slayer think he slays. He is thinking that people have a belief that they are the ones who have killed. And the people who get killed, the people who are slain, think that they are the ones who have been killed. But Brahma, in a very ironic tone, says that they know not well the subtle ways. They do not know that they are not the killers, or they are not the ones who have died. Actually, I am the killer and I am the one who is killed. In the last line of the first stanza, I keep and pass and turn again. The poet has actually affirmed Brahma's thought that he kills the body, but he keeps the soul. He passes the soul in another body, and that turns again in the form of a rebirth. So Brahma is the creator. He may kill the body, but the soul always lives, which continues for ages to come. Brahma, with a self-belief, is trying to say that nobody is far from me and I have forgotten none. They feel that they are far from me and they have forgotten me, but to me everyone is near. I am the shadow and I am the sunlight. If people are having good times, or if people are having bad times, if they are going through ups and downs, if there is a shadow and if there is a sunlight, I am the one who brings the shadow and I am the one who creates sunlight. He strongly says that to me, even the gods who have disappeared from the earth appear before me. And to me, success and failure both are the same. Shame and fame both are the same, because I alone is the creator of everything on this earth. Brahma here again affirms that he is the universal spirit. He is the universal essence. He says, those who leave me out, I even call them. And I am the wings. I allow the people to fly. I create distrust. I create doubt. I create mistrust. I create suspense. I am the doubter and I the doubt. I am the song which the Brahmin is singing. If people leave me out, I will still call them. If they abuse me, I will still remember them. So he is talking about his own power, which is universal. In the fourth quatrain of the poem Brahma, Ralph Waldo Emerson speaks about his love for goodness and how goodness within a human being can help him reach God. He says that strong and powerful gods, Brahma is speaking, that strong and powerful gods try to fathom me. They try to reach my place, but they did not get me. the sacred seven, which is called Saptarishis, desired to have me, but even they could not reach me. But you, he's trying to say, you, a simple person who is humble, who is a lover of goodness, could find me, because there is God in you and you are trying to help others, and therefore you are able to find me, but not those strong and powerful gods. And the last part of the last line, turn thy back on heaven. There is no need for you to go to church or a mosque or a temple, but all you need to do is to turn inside instead of going outside, because it is in your goodness in which lies my essence. Thus, the poem Brahma is an extension of American romanticism known as transcendentalism. According to this philosophy, we all of us are the product of same one soul. We are born out of the same parent. The self of one individual is as important as the self of the other individual. But only thing is that we should learn to rely on ourselves. And this poem preaches this.